Hi, my name is Heather the Heat Hardy, and you're watching Blue Blood Sports TV.
This is Amanda the Real Deal Serrano, and you're watching Blue Blood Sports TV.
Hi, I'm Courtney.
And I'm Janita.
And you're watching Blue Blood Sports TV.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV, back at y'all with another one. So, light heavyweight, undefeated WBA world champion Dimitri Bivol calls out super middleweight, 168 pound, undefeated British fighter, and currently WBA world champion Calum Smith. Dimitri Bivol stated that he is willing to go down to 168 to face off against Calum Smith. He says he would love to face off against Artur Beterbiev, but the way things are standing currently with, the pandemic and everything being on lockdown and sports being suspended, he believes the fight between himself and Artur Beterbiev is a major fight, and he wants that fight to be seen, and he wants it to take place in the States. And he says that a big crowd should be present on hand for that type of fight. So he don't believe that fight could come to fruition just yet. That's a unification bout in the light heavyweight division. But he says that he definitely wants to face off against Calum Smith. Calum Smith has sports a record of 27-0, 19 by way of knockout. He's the WBA super middleweight world champion, 168 pounds. And oddly enough, the thing about this is Calum Smith is the bigger boxer, right? Dimitri Bivol will be coming down in weight, but Calum Smith is the bigger boxer. He stands at 6'3". He has a 78-inch arm reach, right? That's enormous for a 168-pounder, right? He definitely should be campaigning at the light heavyweight division, but making weight is a skill just like a jab, anything else inside the ring, right? It's an art to making the weight. So Calum Smith, is a very big guy. Calum Smith and Dimitri Bivol will be a hardcore boxing fan's dream, right? Dimitri Bivol is undefeated as well, 17-0, 11 by way of knockout. Oddly enough, he stands only 6 feet tall. He's 29 years of age. Calum Smith is 30 years old. Most people consider Dimitri Bivol a pretty small light heavyweight, right? So he's from Kazakhstan, just like Gennady Triple G Golovkin. He's considered a very skilled boxer. He beat Isaac Chalemba, he beat Jean Pascal, he beat Joe Smith Jr. So he has some credible wins on his resume, although he only has 17 fights, but he's 17-0. And like I said, Calum Smith is the more has the more experienced boxer, but Dimitri Bivol has a decorated amateur background as well. So Calum Smith is a superstar over in the UK. He beat George Groves, people want to see him in big fights. He's been calling out Saul Canelo Alvarez. He beat Rocky Fielding for the WBC silver middleweight title and the vacant British Boxing Board of super middleweight title. And then Rocky Fielding fights Canelo Alvarez for a vacant WBA interim title, beats him, and Canelo Alvarez gets considered the WBA super middleweight world champion, and we know why that is, right? But so Calum Smith has been calling out Saul Canelo Alvarez for quite some time, stating that if you're going to be considered WBA champion, I'm the real champion, let's go ahead and fight and see who the true WBA champion is. But we know that his call out went unanswered as Canelo Alvarez decided to go in the direction of facing off against another British superstar boxer in Billy Joe Saunders, who happens to be undefeated as well. But Billy Joe Saunders is coming up in weight. He's coming up from 54, 60, and now 68. So there's a total difference between Billy Joe Saunders and Calum Smith, right? I just said that Calum Smith is a very big super middleweight to begin with, standing at 6'3". And he usually weighs about, the night of the fight, 182 pounds, right? Upwards of 180 pounds after he weighs in at 168. So this would be a hardcore boxing fan's dream, this fight between Calum Smith and Dimitri Bivol. They both technical, they both have power. I would personally favor Calum Smith because he just has the reach advantage. He has power. I think he has a slight bit more power than Dimitri Bivol, although he's in the lower weight class, right? And Dimitri Bivol said that on the day of the weigh-in, he fights at one light heavyweight at 175. He says, but the morning of the weigh-in, he eats breakfast and everything. So he's not truly like most people consider him. He's not truly a light heavyweight, right? He's really a super middleweight campaigning at light heavyweight. But Caleb Smith has a 78-inch arm reach. So that arm reach advantage, I believe, is going to play a strong part in this fight. And the fact that he has a height and he has power and he's technical as well, I'm favoring Caleb Smith to win this fight over Dimitri Bivol. But this fight is a barn burner, and this is a hardcore boxing fan's dream. It's going to be a technical, it's going to be a chess match. It's, you know, I don't think it's going to be so exciting as far as fireworks and things of that nature. That may take place later on in the fight, but in the beginning of the fight, a chess match, it's going to be about, it's a thinking man's game. It's going to be the sweet science and defense and so on and so forth. But I would love to see this fight. But like I state, I'm favoring Caleb Smith to win this fight. So let's see how this all plays out. As Dimitri Bivol said, he's definitely willing to come down to 168 to make it happen. So let's see if it happens. But that's all I got for y'all. Y'all already know what it is. It's your boy Blue, Blue Blood Sports TV. Hate, like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, hit the bell icon to get all the new notifications. Follow me on Instagram at Blue Blood Sports TV, all one word. Y'all already know what it is. Shout out to the entire LDBC. Shout out to New Media. Shout out to Black Media Row. Make sure you like and share these videos. That's all I got for y'all. Peace.
Hey, this is Jasmine. Thank you for watching Blue Blood Sports TV. Hola, soy Jasmine. Gracias por ver Sangre Azul Deportes TV. Gracias.